Hi everybody, I'm Munun Ahmed. I'm taking your History of English Literature course. Let's have some idea about neoclassical literature. That is totally literature, and it has started in between 1660 to 1798, okay? And you have to remember that it was a time of both the formality and artificiality. And most of the important thing is you have to remember three stages, because it was broken down at that the period was totally broken down into three period, and the periods are Restoration period, Augustan period, and the Age of Johnson. As you know that neoclassical means new means new, and classical, it's already involved in Roman and Greek literature. And try to remember another thing, some other writers, those are involved in that era. There is John Milton, John Dryden, Alexander Pope, Jonathan Swift, and Thomas Gray, who was already involved in Churchyard School of Poets, and some other poet related to William Blake, Robert Burns. And there are some differences between neoclassical literature and Romanticism as well, because neoclassical literature ended in 1798. That is the starting point of Romantic literature. So there are some differences between neoclassical and Romantic literature. So these are already involved in objectivity, order, and restraints. And Romanticism was all about imagination and emotion. So try to get some information related to neoclassicism and Romanticism. And most of the important thing is in neoclassical literature, we have got John Milton, Alexander Pope, John Dryden, Jonathan Swift, Daniel Defoe, who was a writer of Robinson Crusoe, and some romantic writers. And most importantly, we need to remember William Wordsworth, and after that we will try to remember other poets as well. But today I'm going to ending up, it's all about neoclassical literature. What are the points, what are the important points we need to remember, and how we can make some differences between Romanticism and Neoclassicism. Best of luck everybody, stay fine, stay at home, take care.